Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. Today we are going to discuss part 2 of chapter Physical Education and Sports for Children with Special Needs. Today we will be studying the following topics: Special Olympics Bharat, Paralympics and Deaflympics. Special Olympics Bharat. We have already discussed this topic earlier in the chapter Olympic Value Education, and today we are going to discuss it again in a bit more detail in this video. So, it is basically an officially organized program of Special Olympics International. The Special Olympics International was started by Eunice Kennedy Shriver, who is the sister of John F. Kennedy, the former president of USA. It is a movement that uses sports as a catalyst to change the lives of children and adults with intellectual disabilities or mentally challenged persons. We have already discussed that Special Olympics is basically organized for the person who are intellectually disabled or have some different mental disabilities. We will only discuss the points which we have not discussed earlier. It was founded in 1987 as Special Olympics India and changed to Special Olympics Bharat in 2001. We know that the last name of this Special Olympics, like Special Olympics Bharat or Special Olympics New York, so the last name basically suggests of which country is it. So in 1987 it was founded as Special Olympics India, but in 2001 it changed to Special Olympics Bharat. It is recognized by the Government of India as a national sports federation for the development of sports opportunity for the people with intellectual abilities. Means this is a National Sports Federation which is recognized by the Government of India for the development of sports opportunities with intellectual disabled people. There are a number of coaches with 8,50,875 athletes across the country under the Special Olympics Bharat program. Means under this program there are a number of coaches with a lot of athletes across the country. Mission. Now let us talk about what is the mission of Special Olympics. Its mission is to provide sports training and organized sports competition throughout the year for children and adults with intellectual disabilities. That means its basic aim or its basic mission is to provide the sports training for those children and adults who are intellectually disabled, and it organizes the sports competition for such people, giving them persistent opportunities to develop physical fitness, demonstrate courage, experience joy, and to participate in sharing of gifts, skills, and friendship with their families, other Special Olympics athletes, and the community. We know that such people who are disabled, especially the people who are intellectually disabled, who have different kind of mental disabilities, they are generally neglected in our society. But to give them opportunities, the Special Olympics program is organized so that the person with intellectual disabilities can develop their physical fitness, they can show their courage, they can also experience joy like the normal people, and they can also participate in sharing of gifts, skills, and friendship with their families. And other Special Olympics athletes, means their mates whom with they play, and the community. oath of Special Olympics Bharat. It is that, let me win, but if I cannot win, let me brave in the attempt. As we know, it is not necessary that we win every time, and victory is not the only thing that we need to achieve in the life. Sometimes, we need to achieve the experiences. Every time, it is not necessary that we win in everything, but sometimes the experiences are more good to achieve than the victory. So, the oath also conveys the same message that let me win, but if I cannot win, then let me brave in the attempt. Goal. What is the goal of Special Olympics? Its goal is to provide chance to differently abled people to develop physical fitness and focus on their holistic development. Means, basically the Special Olympics wants that a chance or opportunity should be provided to the people who are differently abled so that they can develop their physical fitness and they can focus on their overall development in each and every aspect, whether it be physical, social, emotional or mental. Now let us talk about the achievements in the field of Special Olympics programs. Special Olympics Bharat has been organizing national games since 2002. We know that Special Olympics Bharat is a national sports federation. So it has been organizing the national games since 2002. And some of the games or the main categories are national games, national floor hockey championship, National Football and Table Tennis Championship, National Volleyball and Basketball Championship, National Badminton Championship. A total of 885 athletes have participated in the 8 World Summer Games and 5 World Winter Games between 1987 and 2015. Means, from India, there are 885 athletes who have participated in the 8 World Summer Games and 5 World Winter Games, which were held between 1987 and 2015. Its athletes have won 359 gold, 353 silver and 423 bronze medal in these games. These are the achievements of the players in the field of Special Olympics games. Approximately 383 Indian athletes have participated in Special Olympics Regional Asia Pacific Games. In the Regional Asia Pacific Games, 383 athletes from India have participated. The competitions are organized at local, district, state, national and international levels. Means the competitions for Special Olympics program are organized at almost all levels. Now let us talk about the benefit of the Special Olympics program. It improves physical fitness and motor skills. We have already discussed what are motor skills. These are the skills that we require for a specific work. So, when the intellectually disabled people participate in the programs of Special Olympics, they can improve their physical fitness and they can also improve their motor skills. And this in turn leads to the increment of the self-confidence and a more positive self-image of that person, forges friendship and ensures increased family support. When the person who are intellectually disabled, they participate in such programs, they are supported by their friends and family and the friendship also becomes stronger. It helps in building leadership, promoting health of athletes and building communities. By participating in these programs, the people who are intellectually disabled, they can build leadership skills in them, and they can also promote or improve their own health and build communities. It helps in strengthening athletes mentally, socially, physically, and emotionally. Means in an overall strengthening takes place in the athletes. Paralympics. This topic has already been discussed in detail in the previous video of chapter Olympic Value Education. You can go to that video for the detailed explanation of Paralympics. The same topics are covered in this chapter also. Deaflympics. The Deaflympics are another type of games which are organized for the athletes who have some hearing impairment or are deaf. We know who is the deaf person, the one who cannot hear at all. Earlier, these games were known as World Games for the Deaf. The Deaflympics are an IOC sanctioned event, means these are also organized and affiliated to the International Olympic Committee, and in these games the deaf athletes compete at an elite level. In these games, the symbols of starting the game like starter's gun, bullhorn commands or referee whistles are not used like we use in Olympics, Paralympics and even the Special Olympics, because the participants in those games are not having any hearing impairment, but in the Deaflympics the athletes have hearing impairment. So these symbols of starting the game are not used, but instead any visual signal like showing flag or something else is used to alert the participants. These games are more than just the world's second oldest multiple sports after Olympics. As we know, there are a variety of games under the Olympic Games. Similarly, under the Deaflympics also, there are a lot of games available for the deaf athletes. These games are the world's fastest growing sports event. The Deaflympics are the world's fastest growing sports events. These are held once in 4 years, just like the Olympic Games, Paralympics Games. Now, the first Deaflympics were held in Paris in 1924. These were the first ever international sporting event for athletes with a disability, means these were organized even before the Special Olympics, which are organized for the person with intellectual disability. And the Deaflympics are the first games which are organized for the athletes with disability. And these were firstly organized in 1924 in Paris. Only 148 athletes from 9 European countries participated in this game. Means the Deaflympics that were held in Paris in 1924, only 9 European countries participated. These games were not held twice due to World War II. Means when the World War II was going on, so these games were not held twice due to the World War. From 1924 to 1965, these games were officially called the International Games for the Deaf. These are basically some different names given to the Deaflympics at different times, like International Games for the Deaf, International Silent Games, or World Games for the Deaf, World Silent Games, and now finally in 2001, these games were declared as Deaflympics, and since 2001, we call these games as Deaflympics. The motto, what is the motto of Deaflympics is equality through sports, means equality for all persons, whether the person is disabled or he or she is a normal person. Every person should get equal opportunities. Every person should be equal. Till now, the Deaflympics have been hosted by 36 cities in 21 countries. Means, till 2020, these Deaflympics games have been hosted by 36 cities in 21 countries. The main purpose is to provide opportunities to persons with hearing disability to participate in allied sports. All the people have the right to participate in games to develop in this field also. So the people who have hearing disability, they are provided with the opportunity of Deaflympics to participate in allied sports. The athlete having a hear loss of at least 55 decibel in their better ear are allowed to participate in Deaflympics. Means this is the category as we read in the Paralympics also. The athletes have some special category of disability to participate in the games. So the athletes having a hear loss of at least 55 decibel in their better ear, which is some better than the other ear, they are allowed to participate in the Deaflympics. Hearing aid or some another instrument, these kinds of instruments are not allowed to be used in the competitions because these are basically organized due to the hearing impairment. And if hearing aid is used, then there is no use of these games. Now here is the table of the Summer Deaflympics that have been held so far. Please have a look at them. This is the table showing the list of Winter Deaflympics in different countries and their host cities in various years. That's all for today. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.